If we're the owner of a call option with a $50 strike price, then the payoff at expiration, so if we're just talking about the value of that position, if the stock is below 50, we wouldn't exercise it because we can buy it for cheaper than the option that the call option is giving us. But if the stock goes above 50, we would exercise our option to buy at 50 and say the stock is at 60, the underlying stock is at 60 on that date at the expiration date. Then we would exercise our option to buy at 50 and sell at 60 and make $10. So we would essentially get this upside above 50 on the stock. And if we think about this is the actual value of the position, if we want to factor in how much we paid for the option, we would just shift this down by $10. Because as the holder, we would pay $10 for that. So it would look like this. We would essentially, if we don't exercise the option, we lose the amount of money. That was a loss that we had to pay for the option. But then above that, we break even at $60, and then we make money above that. Because at $60, the value of our option is $10, but we paid $10 for it. So that's our break even, but then we make money after that. So this is from the perspective of the holder. This is from the perspective of the holder of the call option. This is the holder of the call option. What would it look like if you're the writer of the call option? If you're the person selling the right to buy the stock? If this person right over here, if the holder has the right to buy at $50, someone must be selling them that right. Someone must be agreeing to say, hey, I will essentially sell that to you at that price. So if you're the writer of the put, so let's see, we have the holder in green. We have the holder in green. But what if you were the writer? You're essentially the counterparty on that option. You're the person agreeing to uphold that option. So if the option never gets exercised, then the writer doesn't have to lose any money. But if the option does get exercised, then all of a sudden the writer starts to lose money. Because if the writer doesn't own the stock, and let's say the stock is at $60, this guy, the holder, can exercise his option to buy at 50. The writer would then have to go buy the stock on the market for $60 and sell it for 50. So they would lose $10. So the writer's payoff would look something. It would look something like this. Once again, it's the mirror image of the payoff of the holder. If you think about the profit of the writer, if the option is never exercised, then the holder just gets to keep the $10 that they were paid for, that they sold the right for. But then if the option is exercised, then they start to lose money. And their break even, once again, is at $60. And anything below that, then they start to lose more and more money. But once again, these are the mirror images of each other. And if you were to add up these two lines, it would be break even, because these parties are the ones who are exchanging money between. If this guy makes $10, this guy's losing $10, or vice versa.